Whether you're worshiping here in person, live online, or on YouTube, we invite you to be a part of our service as members of the Worship and Music Committee lead us in worship. We honor and thank the Haudenosaunee people as our community partners and traditional inhabitants of this land upon which we gather for worship here in Haldimand County, land named as part of the Haldimand Tract Treaty. This land acknowledgement marks a small but essential step toward reconciliation. Let's stand and sing our first hymn. It's 221 of Voices United, or you'll see it on the screen. Sing Praise to God.
Creator in a way that sparked a movement and a new understanding of God. We light this rainbow candle as a visible reminder of the radical inclusivity shown to us by Jesus, who calls us to follow him.
Let's join in the prayer of the day. Come to us, Holy God, as we gather before you.
Encircle us with your love.
Bless us with your sustaining presence.
Surround us with your grace.
Draw us round your living word.
And bind us to one another.
And our assurance of God's love and forgiveness. Sometimes we hurt others. Sometimes we hurt ourselves, and sometimes we hurt God. Our prayer of confession is a chance to say we're sorry.
Gracious God, we find it so easy to sin for grace, but much more difficult to admit that we fail again and again. To honor you in what we say and do, and also we know that your forgiving love enables us to begin again, day after day after day. We are raised up, we are forgiven, we are unconditionally loved. Thanks be to God. Amen.
And our next hymn is from Voices United 624, Give to Us Laughter.
Computer that's right here next to me. After each sound, I want you to first try and figure out what this sound is, and then try to decide if you think it's a happy, joyful sound or not. Okay? So listen very carefully, listening ears. Here's our first sound. Any guesses? That was a hyena laughing. That noise came from an animal. Did you know that? Well, hyenas laugh whenever they're frustrated, excited, or they're afraid. So they make that sound a lot when they're hunting. Now, that sound kind of made me smile because whenever people laugh, I tend to laugh. But that's probably not such a happy sound if you're getting hunted by a hyena. All right, let's listen to the next one. Jingle bells, because it reminds me a lot of the Christmas season. And the Christmas season is so full of such happy, joyful things. I just love it. So for me, jingle bells is a very happy sound. Let's listen to our third one. Could you hear that one? That one was a little bit softer. That was the sound of a mosquito. I don't like that sound at all because I don't like mosquitoes, but mosquitoes really seem to like me, which doesn't work out very well. Well, the psalm says to make a joyful noise. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean singing or playing an instrument. Making a joyful noise is any way that we give thanks to God and praise Him for all that He does for us. Whether or not that sound is pretty, now, that is a different story. The psalm also commands all the earth to make a joyful noise. Now, I've never heard a mosquito sing before, but maybe the mosquito's joyful noise is the buzzing sound we just heard. All of creation makes a joyful noise, just in different ways. Well, just as God created us and cares for us and loves us, He also loves our joyful noises. So let's make our joyful noises loud and proud as we praise Him and give Him thanks. Can you guys please fold your hands, bow your heads, and repeat after me for a prayer? Dear God, we thank and praise You.
We thank and praise You
for all that You do.
For all that You do.
Help our joyful noises.
Help our joyful noises
to be strong.
To be strong.
I love You, God.
Amen.
Thanks, everyone.
Okay, so you heard all those three and their explanation, which ones are happy and which ones aren't. How can we make a joyful noise? Do you like to sing? Remember that God made each one of us, and we should thank Him and praise Him for all He does for us. And like in the video, we should realize that we aren't the only ones who can praise God. That in all creation can make joyful sounds. We just do them in different ways. And at the end of the day, we should give thanks to God for His goodness and sing His praises, whether we sing or dance, pray, or whatever way the Spirit moves us, let us give thanks to God. Let's say a quick prayer before you go off to Sunday school. Dear God, help us to make a joyful noise by singing Your praises and giving thanks to You. Amen.
And again, our scripture reading this morning is Psalm 100. Sing to the Lord, all the world. worship the Lord with joy. Come before him with happy songs. Acknowledge that the Lord is God. He made us, and we belong to him. We are his people. We are his flock. Enter the temple gates with thanksgiving. Go into its courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise him. The Lord is good. His love is eternal, and his faithfulness lasts forever.
This morning, I'd like to offer an interesting take on the reflection. I'd like to play you a song from the Broadway show Sister Act, the play version of the movie that featured Whoopi Goldberg. Our scripture reading this morning tells us to praise God, thank God for all the amazing gifts we have been given, and then go out into the world and share that love that we have received with everyone. Each and every person we meet, which is exactly where our Broadway music picks up. The song is called Raise Your Voice. It was not a song that was in the movie, but in this song, the woman who plays Whoopi Goldberg's character from the movie discovers that the choir of nuns she is living with can actually sing and encourages them to raise their voices. So let's listen.
Thank you.
the rafters. Doesn't that make you want to leap up and speak out? First time I heard it, it made me want to hit repeat so that I could listen to it over and over again. Then it made me want to get up and dance. One of the downfalls of only listening to a song once is that you don't always catch all the lyrics. So I wanted to really make sure I share them with you. The first rule of singing, get the rafters ringing. Toss everything in. Dig down deep inside. When you've got a song worth hearing, just keep your fear from interfering. And let that sucker burst through. Lift it up to heaven. Come on, don't be shy. If you feel it, why conceal it? Let your soul rejoice. Raise the stakes. Raise your game. Raise your voice. So, how do we make a joyful noise to God? How do you raise your voice? I think every time we sing or pray or laugh with someone, every time we speak up for someone who can't speak for themselves, we raise our voices to God. We make a joyful noise. There has recently been a lot of research on laughter. Personally, I think it's a remarkably powerful thing. Researchers say that laughter really has a bonding function between individuals. Robert Levinson, a psychology professor at the University of California, Berkeley, invited couples into his lab and asked each partner to discuss something that irritated him or her about the other partner. The couples who tackled a stressful situation with laughter not only felt better in the moment, but had higher levels of relationship satisfaction and stayed together longer than couples who didn't crack a smile. I suppose that's something to think about in your relationship with not just your spouse, but with everyone you interact with. Study after study has pointed to the health benefits of laughter. Researchers show that laughing can improve memory and immunity, increase blood flow, help regulate blood sugar levels, and improve sleep. Now you might say that that's all well and good, but what does that have to do with God? Laughter removes all barriers. When people are laughing together, there are no age differences, no racial barriers, and no economic distinctions. We are all just people, celebrating one of the special gifts God gave us that makes us all equal and beautiful in God's eyes. Karl Barth, a Swiss theologian, said, "Laughter is the closest thing to the grace of God." So, if ever someone tells you that it's not appropriate to laugh in church, well, you just tell them that you are just flexing the muscles of one of the best gifts God ever granted us. Laughter is a joyful noise, but sometimes we are called to be a little louder. We are called to speak from a more serious place. Although no less beautiful or powerful or life-changing, there are people and places in our lives and in our world that are silent or have been silenced. We see it every day on the TV, in the newspaper. We see it walking down our streets or through the hallways of buildings we walk through. People suffering from verbal, physical, financial, or sexual abuse who are feeling oppressed or alienated. People who are alone by the actions of someone else or by their own doing, and who now feel muzzled by their isolation. People who work three jobs and still don't make enough money to pay the bills and put food on the table for their families. Racial, social, or gender inequalities that make it so one person has while another has not, simply because of the color of their skin, the race or gender they were born with, or the orientation they chose, or that has chosen them.
In Proverbs 31, verses 8 to 31, it says, "Speak out for those who cannot speak, for the rights of all the destitute. Speak out, judge righteously, defend the rights of the poor and needy." When we raise our voices, when we speak up, when we shout at the top of our lungs, that is not okay. We truly are living out the words Jesus spoke in Matthew's gospel when it says, "Truly I tell you, just as you did it to one of the least of these who are members of my family, you did it to me." So why don't we? What holds us back from taking the plunge, from saying what we know needs to be said? Why don't we raise our voices and make a joyful noise for someone who can't seem to utter a sound? Fear, I am sure, is a big reason. What will happen if I do stir the pot? What will people say or do? How will I be labeled if I do that? What lasting effect might that have on my life, my family and friends, and my job? Or maybe it's a lack of confidence in our ability to actually affect any change. We are just one person, right? How is one person going to make a difference? The problem is too big. It will never change. And really, it isn't our problem, right? It is happening to someone else. We should just keep our head down and keep moving. But then we remember Jesus' words that continue in Matthew's gospel in the second part of his message, where he says, "For I was hungry, and you gave me no food. I was thirsty, and you gave me nothing to drink. I was a stranger, and you did not welcome me. Naked, and you did not give me any clothing. Sick and in prison, and you did not visit me. Truly I tell you, just as you did not do it to one of the least of these, you did not do it to me." And so we know, deep down in hearts, in the place where the Spirit resides, that it is our problem, and we can affect change. Although the words and actions we are called to speak and do are sometimes difficult and uncomfortable, and we would rather not do them, when we do do them, and keep our fears from interfering, as the video said, we know that we are not alone when we do it. We are supported, we are helped, and we are pushed forward together with the Holy Spirit, with God in our lives. And when we feel disappointed or deflated that all our work doesn't make a difference, that it takes so long, and it doesn't seem to be affecting that change we want to see, I know of a Zen saying that says, "Water is fluid, soft and yielding, but water will wear away rock, which is rigid and cannot yield." As a rule, whatever is fluid, soft, and yielding will overcome whatever is rigid and hard. What is soft is strong. We are soft, gentle beings. We are easily hurt, both physically and emotionally. Our relationship with each other and with the world are at times, it seems, held together with the thinnest of threads. But we are called, encouraged, and sometimes pushed to speak up and to speak out, to raise our voices to God in the glory of God and in God's name, for ourselves and for others, to sing, to pray, to laugh, to speak up, to live as God's people, as messengers in the world, reminding ourselves and each other that we are precious God's eyes. We are loved without condition, and we should celebrate this gift of love every single day. So let us go out into the world, confident in this new love, sure of the presence of God, the Spirit in our lives, and sing from the rooftops and on the streets, "We are loved. We are loved. We are loved." Amen. hymn is Voices United 820, Make a Joyful Noise. Let's make our noise joyful.
Creation joins together to praise and glorify God, the Creator. each of us are God's own child, weak and erring though we may be. Yet God's goodness and mercy, we are loved. We gather together to celebrate and give thanks for each other as we are all a part of God's own family, and for the strength and encouragement we can give to each other on our faith journey. God's unfailing love always goes with us as we travel along, and God's faithfulness is utter, dependable for us now and for all the generations that follow. Today we gather to pray for those people and places that feel separated by your love, those who are ill in body, mind, or spirit, those who are grieving a loss of a loved one, of independence, of friendship. May they all feel your love, feel your health, healing presence in their hearts and minds. We now bring to mind people we have special concerns for this morning. We offer them to you now in the silence of our hearts, knowing that you know all that we offer and in your love answer.
Let us sing together, Lord, listen to your children praying. The words are on the screen.
Lord, send your spirit in this place.
that suffered a medium stroke on Monday. The family, friends, and our local churches have rallied around, and we wanted to let our friends at South Tuba know that Reverend Bill is on the mend. God bless Jane. So that's Reverend Bill, who was here for a period of time, and we all enjoyed it, and so we wanted to share that with you and keep him in your prayers. Now, starting along with the announcements as printed in the bulletin, today is a special day for Sunday school. They're having a pool party at Andy and Janelle's, which is in Cuba, and for South End Drive. If you're planning on going, a lot of the things are being supplied, but if you could take a salad or a dessert to finish off the meal, that would be greatly appreciated. And don't forget your swimsuit, your towels, and maybe a lawn chair. And Pastor Don will be on vacation until the 30th of June, and so Reverend Diane Everett is covering for emergency care. Technology is wonderful. There's a phone number there for Diane as well, Reverend Diane. And through the summer, there's going to be a little different approach as far as some of the things that we're doing during our hour here. And there's a little note there about Canada Highlights, and if you have something that you want to share, pictures that you've taken in your travels, there's instructions there. Now I see we've missed the deadline, but I'm sure that maybe they would take a few late ones as well. And that will be put into a slideshow for the 2nd of July worship service. Also, they're asking that if we have a favorite hymn or some favorite scriptures that you would like to share with others, they're asking that you put it on a little piece of paper, which is supplied in the vestibule, and put it in the appropriate pails, and then they will be used where appropriate. And so it will be interesting to see what old hymns and favorite scriptures will be. And one more thing. During the summer, we're going to have a little more relaxed, casual worship. And we're able to come in more casual and relaxed clothing. So it's listed there. I'll let you read it. I don't need to read it for you, but feel free to come in relaxed clothing. But don't forget, the air conditioning will be on, so if you need something to put over your shoulders, so be it. And one other thing that we're going to be experimenting with, possibly, is that if you didn't quite get your coffee finished when you were having your breakfast, put it in a travel mug and bring it along, and you can sip away as you're sitting in your pew. But be sure that it's a travel mug that's got a lid. We don't want any spills, and to make more work for our caretakers. There will be coffee hour following the service, so you can bring your mug along and fill it up again. So just take note of those three announcements that are going to make our summer services more interesting and fun. Today is the special offering for Sunday School. The envelopes are on the table as you're going out of the sanctuary. And they wanted to share that this Sunday and the last Sunday of July, those collections will be given to the Wonder Camp, which will be run here 31st of July through to the 3rd of August. So just as a reminder that if you would like to help with the Wonder Camp, that's a good way of doing it. Lunch Bunch will be getting together this Tuesday, and it's going to be at Caruso's in Cayuga.
12:15. Howie, anything to add to that?
What's that difference?
I didn't know if there was something else you wanted to make mention of with the lunch bunch.
Yes, I don't know. I was not there this past week, so if there was anything special going on.
It was the best ever.
Yeah. Yes, George. Was there five there last week?
There was.
It's happening next weekend. Yeah. And I'm hoping we're ready for it. Because I've been going in many directions this year, it seems. And so this week is my final week to just check with everybody and make sure that everything that we have decided and offered to do is really happening. So that's great. On Friday night, between 7 and 9, we will set things up so we're ready for Saturday morning. Saturday morning, if the people that are working on the barbecue and things, we'll have everything in the foyer ready for that so we can just pull that stuff out. So if those people would come around 7 o'clock in the morning so we can get that all sorted out. This morning I received the final payment for the vendors. So the vendors are all ready to go, so that'll be good too. If you're bringing in something for the garage sale section, you can bring it anytime the church is open this week and put it in the very back classroom, Sunday school classroom, in the back corner, or the one next up on the wall. So the back two classrooms, anything that you can bring in can be housed in there, and then we'll pull it out Friday night to start setting up the tables. If you're bringing baking, you can bring it the Friday night between 7 and 9 or early Saturday morning so the ladies have a chance to price everything and get that all organized. Okay? And I hope to see you all. It's going to be beautiful weather and nice and sunny, and we're going to have a great time. So make sure you join us. I have one more little tiny announcement that has nothing to do with Wowza. Last Thursday, I became a great-grandmother for the third time. My one grandson, Tyrell, who you might remember, used to come here with us. He has a daughter. Her name is Kalani Dawn Rose. Yeah, very nice. Yeah. Everybody's helping.
Thank you, Linda. I think that pretty much fills in all of the blanks that I had for the Wowza, so we look forward to seeing folks here on Saturday, the 1st of July. Can you believe it?
No.
Wonder Camp is coming up as well. It's the 31st of July through to the 3rd of August from 9 a.m. till 12. There's a little note there that if you have questions or you want to help out or whatever, be in touch with Joan Melick or Janelle Richardson. And we ask that if you have folks that family or neighbors or friends that are in nursing homes or hospital, try to be in touch with them either with a card or with a phone call. The lists are up for coffee hour and greeting volunteers at the door, and if you can help out with that, that would be wonderful. There are registration forms for Ryerson Camp. They're available in the fellowship hall, so I'm not exactly sure where that is, but we'll ask. And just as the last little notation here about Salvation Army, the food
so it would help out if we could help them with that particular item. I just happened to pick up the sheet that's laying out on the table of some of the items that are on their wish list. And so it's an interesting list, so pick it up, and then when you're at the grocery store next time, you'll maybe remember that there are some things on the list that you might be able to pick up. Now, are there any birthdays or anniversaries to recognize? Okay. Leanne?
Rebecca has finished